In this age of candy-coated, saccharine nonsense aimed at children, it's absolutely refreshing to see some people out there wanting to try and make something unique and different. Enter Hevisaurus, the Finnish heavy metal band for children and for those who think like children, or at least so they say. Having sold over 170,000 records in their home country, at least three sister bands in different languages, a film, and plans for world domination, how did this all come about? It's a short but colourful story involving dinosaurs, Finnish metalheads, a wrestler, and a lawsuit. Our story starts in 2009 with Mirka Rantanen, a drummer, part of the band Thunderstone, watching a Froebelin Palikat concert with his kids, a popular children's music band going since the late 1980s. He envied their work times, since they played for children their concerts used to end in the early afternoon, unlike the usual late nights most other bands had to endure. Having the idea to start his own children's music band, he reached out to some of his friends from his metalhead connections, and they together came up with the idea for Hevisaurus. Nino Laurenne and Alain Vitica came in at this time. Nino Laurenne was the founder of Thunderstone and the band's guitarist, as well as the manager, producer and sound engineer at Helsinki's Sonic Pump Studios. Alain Vitica was part of the band The Milestones as their lead singer and songwriter, as well as working as a scriptwriter for the Finland Comedy Theatre Group. Working together with Rantanen, they thought that heavy metal music for children would be the best, since that's what they're good at, and since every child likes dinosaurs, and that they themselves were dinosaurs in a music sense, the pieces fell together. Working with Michael Starbuck Mahoyati, a wrestler and graphic artist, they designed the band and got the concept art drawn. Alain Vitica would be Hera Hevisaurus, the lead singer and a T-Rex. Nino Laurenne would be Riffy Raffy, the band's guitarist and resident dragon. Mirka Rantanen would be Kompi Monpi, the band's drummer and Apatosaurus. Also joining the band would be Muffy Puffy, bass guitarist and Stegosaurus, and finally Millie Pilly, keyboardist, Triceratops and the band's only female member. Their first album, Jurahevin Kuninkat, or Kings of Jurassic Heavy Metal, released in late 2009 and rose to 5th on the Finnish album charts. It was well received and the band had their first tour later on in November of the same year. With reviews being positive and concerts successful, the band moved on to their second album in 2010, Hermeliskan Yr, or Dinosaurs of the Night. This album peaked at 3rd in the Finnish charts, was the second best-selling album in Finland in 2010, and it earned them an Emma, the Finnish equivalent of a Grammy Award, for Best Children's Album. The band, later in 2010, would enter what I would describe as the dark times. Rantanen ended up in a dispute with Sony Music Finland over the rights and trademarks to the characters. Exact details are hard to come by, but basically from what I have researched, Sony wished to move Hevisaurus on as a brand without input from Rantanen and the others, starting up other language versions of the band as well as wanting German and English equivalents. Rantanen fought against Sony, wanting more say in the band's progress as well as establishing that the characters and the band belonged to him. During this time, Rantanen and Laurenne left Hevisaurus with some of the members who played Hevisaurus in the studio and formed Sauruxset in 2011, another dinosaur-based band using the same costumes and mostly the same names, releasing one album and one live DVD. Sauruxset played their own songs with some Hevisaurus ones live, albeit with a new lead singer. Not too long after though, Sony sued and issued a cease and desist on Sauruxset. In court, Sauruxset was ordered to cease operating and charged an €100,000 fine. It was found in court that Sony owned the rights to the characters and all related trademarks to Hevisaurus. The period after is a bit of a mystery. As far as I can see, Nino Laurenne ended up back with Hevisaurus and remains so to this day, although it's unclear if this was immediately after the court case or sometime after. Mirka Rantanen did not return. Ra, literally meaning Raw, was released later in 2011 with Rahelista Yola, or Roaring Christmas, shortly after. The year also saw the Argentinian Hevisaurus formed and become successful there. Swedish and Hungarian versions of Hevisaurus also released albums at this time, but they didn't grab as much traction as the Finnish or Argentinian bands. After the short but turbulent 2011, in 2012 Hevisaurus released possibly the most experimental album to date, Caronin Lauhikamen Avoitus, or Mystery of the Lost Dragon. Based on a musical that they did, the album takes on an ongoing story narrative and perhaps takes the biggest leaps into much more experimental sounding songs, even touching on death metal on one. This particular album peaked at number one in the Finnish charts.